Back then, and we've had Scotland men. It's now time for Scotland women in this Homeless World Cup here in George Square in Glasgow. And we're in Group A for Scotland against India. Tom Crosby is alongside myself, Carl Patterson, for this one. The sun's still out. We've just seen Scotland's men and the crowd still here to watch the women's side, who have done so well in this tournament.
Yeah, the women's side are in a stronger position than the men's team, of course. There's only 16 teams in the women's competition, so we would expect to see Scotland in the top half of that draw. We'd expect them to be challenging for the Homeless World Cup, but to be honest, there's some very strong teams in the competition. But I must say, if you get the chance, get on youtube.com/homelessworldcup and relive their game from yesterday against Kyrgyzstan. But we've got some tweets coming up on the screen now.
Yep, hashtag HWC2016, Kimmy Renix, great wee afternoon down watching the homeless football, gutted going to have to miss Scotland game, but it's training time, so great stuff for her, who of course very much an athlete. And we've got also Clyde D'Alene, more Homeless World Cup, great place to bring the bairns, watch games and see how many miles per hour your best shot is. Well, there has been some ferocious shots in terms of pace and speed and power, some long range shots today, so great to get your interaction on the Twitter page, so hashtag HWC2016 or Twitter at Homeless World Cup without the O in world. So Scotland, you know, women's time now, and you say they've done so well, and you know, they've won one, you know, lost to Mexico, which was kind of expected. A good 6-3 win against USA first up this morning. Their opposition, and they also have got one win to their name, so good matchup.
It is a good matchup. You'll see the Scottish team, a big range of sizes, but with a lot of skill at the feet. The Indian side, very small and very thin, but still some tough tackles will go in from them as well. Keep your eye on the little number three, I believe it is, Christina Robert Francis. Now, Christina Robert Francis might be the smallest girl on this field, but she also plays rugby as well back home in India.
Well, the teams are out, and Scotland in the blue, India in white. And as I say, the crowd sticking around to watch, predominantly a home crowd, of course, on this pitch one. And Scotland's women playing their third game of the day, as I say, they've won one and lost one in this second phase now that the women are into today, ahead of obviously all the trophy games to come, with all the finals on Saturday, of course. And it's obviously free to come and watch the games, and it's great so many are watching our coverage as well. And you know, if the sun sticks around, I'm not too sure the weather's might be quite as good as this tomorrow, but hopefully the weather's great and people are still going to come out and support Scotland, support all the good football from all the different parts of the world. Scotland's women ranked 7th before coming to this tournament, India 5th, so tight in terms of rankings, but players move in. It shows as well about the organisations as well and how well they bring players into each tournament, because you can only play in one tournament. So on paper and maybe on the set-ups of both sides, it may well be rather close, Tom.
Well, yeah, I think so. I mean, this is the sort of weather that India really thrive in. At Amsterdam last year, we had some torrential rain, maybe 6 out of the 8 days of competition. It was buckets out there, and India really did struggle. But in the sunshine, in George Square, expect to see a lot from this Indian side.
Yep, it's very much traditional Scottish weather. Pinocchio knows just starting now with that one. It's a really good sunny day here in Glasgow. Scotland women get ready, and there is the figure in goals for Scotland. Christy Rogers, such a cult hero. We've seen many great goalkeeping tales, but this Scottish goalkeeper got so much passion, and we're almost ready to go in this one.
Of course, any Scottish fans, keep your eye on the rainbow armband of the little number two, Karen Boggy. She's the captain, she's the talisman, she's the centre, and she's probably the best girl on that pitch.
Yeah, Boggy has done so many good things, but India have it. Wag is the captain. Well, it's an early effort off the post from Francis. Scotland, here is Boggy, got support down this near side with Lynn. And Boggy! That's an excellent start. What a start. 35 seconds, Scotland hit the front.
It felt like 35 yards as well, that kick from the halfway line. Beautiful effort by the Scottish captain. She's capable of doing that from anywhere on the pitch.
Excellent stuff, and She used to play against with Hearts, and maybe showing her skill when she was with Hearts, ladies, because she scored a second in quick succession. It's 2-0, two goals in the space of a minute, and a flyer for Scotland and for Karen Bogie.
Of course, England women did have a tough test against this Indian side. Number two there, Christina Robert Francis, with a tackle on Coombs that led to a very bad injury for England. England now a patchwork of players with three big injuries. But there's Scotland back inside, and I think it's Shillaire in the goal for India palming that one away.
Yeah, Gallagher, who scored a long ranger earlier today, starting with Bogie, and also Courtney Lynn. And obviously the keeper is Chrissy Rogers, who's got the ball now. And looking for Lynn, who's kept out of that orange area, not allowed to go in there, outfield players. Here's Bogie, looking for a very, very quick hat-trick, and not far away. Now here's Ishwara Wag, the captain here with the number three. And calmly back to the Scotland keeper, and so passionate she was. Chrissy Rogers in the penalty shootout yesterday against Kyrgyzstan. And there's a fine play, Stefan, into that corner. Sophie Gallagher, another goal from distance. She's done that once or twice this tournament, and there it is again, 3-0 Scotland.
It's all about the quality of the Scottish finishing that's putting those girls ahead. India, no real response for that yet. They haven't had the composure or the control in front of goal.
Gallagher at the moment is sorting out her shoelaces, back with it. Ball fizzed across by Ipsita Roy. And India trying to get a bit of possession, as they've not had an awful lot, haven't they, go backwards to go forward. Here's Roy now. Trying to dance her way past Gallagher. That was wonderful, wonderful by the football. She's still got it using the boards. Gallagher wins out eventually, and here's Bogie. Back to Gallagher, what an effort that is, what play, little flick by Bogie, 3-1-2, 4-0.
Very well to keep that down, didn't she? She did very well indeed. That was on the outside tip of her right foot.
Hat-trick
time.
There's
another effort. Hat-trick time, Karen Bogie. Fantastic performance by her already. 3.5 minutes gone, and we've got five goals, Callum.
Yes, yeah, superb. And I say, Karen Bogie, she is back as part of the Hearts women's set-up, a side who are in second tier in women's football in Scotland, and were in the top flight last year, so very good club to be playing at a few years back. Now in this Women's World Cup, and looking to get on with it, telling her side to get on with it with this free kick. Indirect, remember. Gallagher now, Bogie once more. Now looking for to get in the act, and the goals is Lynn, not scored yet.
You can see the order coming in from Bogie there, just to calm things down. They have the advantage, they have the overlap, they don't have to pull the trigger, they can just wait and wait and wait for that shot.
So it is Courtney Lynn, as the fans watch on, really are delighted, and almost another goal. Stinger of a shot, and they just haven't got going in this one. 4 and a bit minutes on the clock, 5 goals for Scotland, out by Rogers, and trying to get it there, oh, not quite, for Courtney Lynn.
Kay Musto shook off a rough challenge in that corner, caught an elbow possibly to the mouth.
Musto just coming on in the last few seconds, but there is the goal, and that's a wonderful celebration, wonderful of just this tournament alone. Ipsita Roy with it. 5-1, and she was happy with that goal. Musto trying to get in the act, coming off the bench and almost getting into that act.
It's a deserved goal by India as well that got them back into this competition a little bit, because they've not been that bad, and that's proved it as well. Ashwara Wag, the captain and number three, slotting home India's second. It's only 3 goals in it now.
Yeah, in this game, 3 goals is never enough. You know, we've seen comebacks. I've seen one or two interesting games, and Italy, I know, were in a comeback earlier, the men's side, never quite made it, but at one stage, or I think 6-1 down at half-time, it was 7-4 by the end. Here's another chance, and look at this, look at this, it's 5-3 now, Roy with another, she's got two, wow. Bogie looking to end the act, she scored three, trying to make it four.
It's Kay Musto on the ball.
Musto with gusto trying to force it through. Lynn. Bogie. Mustel. Bogey strike, it's a good deflection away, a good block away. I can't believe the scoreline. Roy has scored two, doing a defensive job.
It's been a great comeback by India. There's a minute left, and we know that you can score goals very quickly in street soccer. There's enough time for India to get this game back to 5-5, which would be an incredible feat.
Quick line by Rogers, Mustel there, not quite what she was intending, and there you are again, Karen Bogey, just saying, calm down. We had an advantage, it's 5-3, one or two nervous fans in the stand. And coming together, and that is Scotland's way. Coming together so quickly, taken. And here is Bogey, deflected. Not quite, Mustel will collect. Bogey once more across to Lynn, looking to get into this goal scoring sheet, isn't she? Not involved yet. Mustel through. And again, an excellent stop once more by the Indian goalkeeper, Shalaya. Into the final few seconds of this first half, and we have seen a cracking game. Mustel looking to restore the 3-goal advantage, but ran out of time there. Half time, Scotland 5, India 3.
Well, we've seen, haven't we, when India poach and when India push forward, they're able to split open the Scottish defence, but it's Scotland with all the possession, Scotland with the passing game, and India with the counter-attack. We'll see if India can get a couple more and draw this level later.
Again, as we've said, it just shows you what can happen at this tournament, this competition, this World Cup. You know, we kind of thought Scotland were just starting to cruise away with it, and then, boof, there you are, India. Absolutely superb. Let's have a little look at the first half action. And this was some great play by Sophie Gallagher and the 1-2 with Karen Bogey. That was just sensational football.
It's very difficult to keep that ball down, as I said, outside of the right boot. That sort of thing's going to curl away and up, but it was enough to beat the keeper. That's a brilliant effort. Great to see some Scottish flags in the crowd as well.
Yeah, there's plenty of them for sure. Absolutely plenty of them from the home contingent. There's one or two other flags and other jerseys, obviously plenty of support just for the game in general. So, almost ready to go for the second half, and it doesn't look like any changes for Scotland. They've remained with the same four, and they have the lead. 2-goal advantage, they had a bit more than that earlier in this first half. And we're back underway for the second half then. Scotland with it, and looking to get going with a quick flyer like they did in the first half. Oh, that was some coming together. Roy is in! And well, that was very close. She was a bit frustrated that it didn't go in. Could have been 5-4 there. Now losing out there is Courtney Lynn.
And it's interesting how the coming together of Christina Robert Francis and Karen Bogey, two of the smallest people on that pitch, it was like immovable objects colliding.
Back with Chrissy Rogers, looking for Mustel. Decent control. Well, that was high and unintentional, going for the ball. But a huge gasp from the crowd.
It's Francis that's down as well.
And it was very high, but again, I think it was purely just for going for the ball. She looks okay, thankfully.
She's been in the wars, very much so. She's been on the receiving end and been dishing out some of the hardest challenges in the women's competition, Christina Robert Francis. Looks like they're bringing her off.
Yeah, just a little breather, a little check over that she's okay. And game back underway. Owen Rogers just having to make sure, get that into her hands. It was Sangeeta Sekar who's came on from that sub. And here she is on the ball, but it's getting in the way. Oh, and fancying another long-range effort with Sophie Gallagher. Sita Roy. Gallagher's got it back. Bogey. Back with Lynn. Gallagher! And there is the goal advantage again in the two sides. Scotland 6, India 3, and Gallagher with her hat-trick.
It was quite a subdued and bruising start to this half. until Gallagher managed to get her third goal, has maybe sparked a bit more life into this contest.
Well, let me fall kindly for Karen Bogey.
Shillair was more than a match for that, though. Fantastic by the Indian goalkeeper.
Woof! That's an absolute fizzer from the captain, Ishwara Vag. And her second of the game, and Scotland just cannot relax. It's 6-4 in the game, just back to two goals, looking to get another and get their seventh in the game. A lot coming together. Courtney Lynn, and another Indian player, is on the floor. It's a feisty old game, this one.
She's already calling for substitution, Ipsita Roy. And you saw her as she went down rolling. She was calling for that to get her off the field. You can see the leg.
That's a shame. She scored two goals and just limping there. And we'll be a loss because she is a brilliant player for this Indian side. And we've seen that with a couple of goals she scored.
Just Karen Bogey trying to rouse the crowd there, but yet calm her own team. The main difference has been her performance in those first few minutes. That quick hat trick is what separates these sides.
So 4.5 minutes still to play. It's still anyone's game in this format. Here is Bogey. Can she finish? Yes, she can. And that may well settle nerves again. Scoring goals for fun in this game, Karen Bogey. That is her fourth. Scotland seventh, but there is the fifth, and they cannot breathe here, Scotland. They need to keep the composure, but how about that for an effort from Gallagher? Goals flying in one way and the other. There's Bogey, and there's her fifth of the game. Scotland have got eight this time, and just after Secker got in the scoring act, Bogey was there again, three goals again, and the goals just keep continuing for this brilliant crowd.
It's amazing how she brought that ball down while she had somebody attacking her as strongly as that in the back and managed to hit that on the volley. It's clear that her apprenticeship as such at Musselburgh and then followed on at Hearts Ladies has really set her in good stead for this game.
Yes, Gallagher got space and brilliant stuff there from Seca to get herself in for the block. Gallagher once more. Now on the pitch is Stephanie Tweed, who's came on in the last couple of minutes for Mustel. Tweed again, looking to spin and turn and shoot. Gallagher, it's just a bit too high. Just under 3 minutes left. A pulsating game. Adikari, who has just came on, playing it over to the other side for Seca. Pulomi Adikari, number 10 for Indian side. Gallagher again. Bogey. Turn, flick, trying to get past. Here she is again. And there is a rolling finish, another excellent goal. Sophie Gallagher playing her part in this game. And 9-5, the scoreboard says.
Nearly every goal for this Scottish side has come from either Bogey or Gallagher. Bogey's substituted herself off now that the game possibly isn't in doubt, but it's those two players, they've been the linchpins for this side.
5 for Bogey, 4 for Gallagher, so they, it shows you how well they've done in this game. And now taking the time, just over 90 seconds left. Another stinging shot from Gallagher. On now is Paige Riggins. And she's in there, no nonsense, getting that ball back. Here's Gallagher now. Riggins in some space. Wanting it. Oh, is that an intentional dummy? I'm not too sure for Tweed. Sure she'll claim it was intentional. But India have done well to win it back. And well saved by Chrissy Rogers. There was she out of her goal there. No penalty's been given. The referee's given a penalty. Surprise the Scotland team. But chance here to make it 9-6. And it's a well taken penalty for Pulomi Adikari, who came on in the second half And three goals again, but I don't think there's any time left. Just under a minute for India. Never say never in this game, though.
No, very true, but this slight defensive frailty from the Scottish side might be a bit dangerous going forward. Normally, in these sorts of high-scoring games, you'd see a sort of 9-3 or a 10-2. But India have managed to get back at Scotland six separate times.
We're into the final 30 seconds. Scotland 9, India 6. One game to come on this pitch, Chile against Netherlands in the women's competition. That'll coming together. Is it going Scotland's way? Well, having a little chat with the referee, Stephanie Tweed, coming together with Adi Carey. And they're just going to eat the time up, aren't they? Gallagher thought about a strike. Riggins. Gallagher tried to lease it from distance this time. And there we are, the final whistle. Scotland 9, India 6, the full-time score. And what a game of football once again between these two sides. And as I said, 3 or 4 minutes into this game, first half, Scotland were cruising. India came back into it and kept on trying to come back, and Scotland tried to score again.
Scotland were always just one or two goals away. And everything, of course, came from Bogey and Gallagher. 4 for 1, 5 for the other. Absolutely brilliant effort. 3 goals at the start for Bogey, and then she's knocked those 2 extra ones in as well. Sublime from that Scottish central unit.
Says a lot that Bogey and Gallagher, you know, Bisa had to go to themselves pretty much there. So big cheers around. Remember, you can get in touch and donate and be part of our coverage. You can donate £5, text the word GOAL to 70660. You can donate to the Homeless World Cup, and also you can get in touch as well through our social media. But here is one of the moments of the game, and Scotland won the game. There was goals of great high quality at both ends, and that was a very, very good effort there by Ashfara Vag, the captain. But it's celebrations for Scotland. Get in touch on Twitter at Homeless World Cup without the O in World. Facebook, it's /Homeless World Cup. YouTube, /Homeless World Cup. If you can relive this game and all the others on our YouTube page. But we'll leave you with the celebrations of Scotland there, and next up in a couple of moments is Chile against Netherlands.